How you doing?
Good, fine.
I hope you had a good break in California.
Yes, we did.
Notice that I hope you had a nice vacation, but I know presidents don't get vacation.
Changes the scene. I must say, the scenery was beautiful.
I'm sure of that.
Got a little tan, you got a little color out there working on it.
Yeah, it's good. Starts out there early, but it really was, I've never seen everything so lush in the wildflowers, everything out in the ground. And this last winter, we had a good rainy season, so maybe that's what it is. About saved up and all bloomed at once.
Did I see you had a problem getting in? Your helicopter had heavy fog or something?
I did not steer the helicopter. I don't know who wrote that thing, but I will tell you, it just was unbelievable. Just a few miles from Point Magoo, we came to a fog bank, came down through it and landed at Point Magoo. They told us that the ranch was fogged in, so we're about 2,400 feet, so we can be right in it, while down on the ground, you're looking up at it, like low clouds. And they told us that we got in the helicopter, we probably had to land at Santa Barbara Airport, and then drive up. We got about to Santa Barbara Airport, and still all fogged in, and the word came from the hill that, why don't we just make a pass, because it was blowing and there was possible a light open up a thing. So we go and just over this solid cloud mass, I had no idea where the hell we were. There was nothing to see but fog. And all of a sudden, he couldn't believe it. Just like that oval there, there's a place called Bald Mountain Ranch. And that's where the helipad is, up there. And all of a sudden, we were looking down at a hole in the fog that just encompassed the top of that mountain. Fog every place else, summer fog. And get into that hole and run the bright sunlight pouring down into it in that very land. And they said it 5 minutes before it hadn't been there.
Gosh.
Well, listen, I know we got some things to talk about in very little time.
First, President of the American Bar and Executive Committee of the Food Association. That's what I always tell you.
Brian Howley, JSP. President Joe Ross, the
aren't they enjoying the president of the National Bar Association? Emmanuel told us, Ted, she really wanted to be here today.
You spoke in Marshall Town.
I sure have.
A couple of times. The boys were there.
Jimmy, let's get this set up right before we are. Here.
Well, just as a rule of in order.
Well, I'm delighted that you would come up here for this. This is to make May 1st Law Day. And the theme is liberty and justice for all. And I think it maybe is kind of appropriate that we're signing on the 15th day of April. The 15th, or the first day of May, is now officially Law Day.
I sure appreciate it, Mr. President. To many, many people in our country, as well as in England.
Or just in the abroad.
Yes, that's what I thought. It takes abroad when we go on our trip. Move
around, take a ride if you want to.
That's a paid commercial.
All XL, a number of sons and I took a trip to the neighboring countries. Paul took copious notes, and so he did briefly. Had a nice trip, everything looking fine. Think you're more popular over there than you've ever been.
Good, good.
Glad to see you. Thanks, sir.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Good to see you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Sir.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Keep up the good work.
Better get these pictures done before you take a look at this. You might want to chase them all out.
Well, I read the letter today, that when you met today, and I now have the brochure of the plan on the, my goodness, this could be quite a installation of it.
We have options now on the two lots on Galena.
Yeah, this
and of course, we own the house next door, and we're starting to work on it this summer, turning the reception area.
My goodness.
And some place for the people to take the little kids.
Well, that's a
that's a long, problem.
Yes, I noticed that. Well, that's a far cry from when there wasn't a tree out in that side lawn, and that's where we played football with the Omari kids.
Yeah. Well, I think that they did a fantastic job in restoring that house. It's a good, horrible shape when we got it.
Well, the only thing I can say is that both my brother and I said, it was bigger than this.
It's always that way. You can't go back.
I know.
Not with the house.
Yeah. Well, I know you have something. These are our people.
No, okay. They're an arch item.
Whoops.
Now you do have to realize that that's in left hand.
Right.
And that's only about half of it. The rest will be on the home itself and what it took to restore and work and research.
If I find any factual errors or anything, maybe you know, I'll send it back to you.
Yeah.
All right, I'll do it.
Use a blue pencil.
I found out, I know that Mooney, here's the things, I found out his memory's a little worse than mine about some things, too.
Well, he's got a good memory, except it just comes up different each time you talk to him.
Uh-huh. Maybe I'll have to make sure.
I think you probably will.
Hi, Matt, of Florida.
Hi, President.
How are you?
We brought you a letter that basically you triggered when you used the words make my day when somebody was talking about possibly raising taxes.
Mm-hmm.
And Bo and I thought it would be an appropriate thing for the Republicans in the House, 146 of us, enough to sustain a veto if you have to use it. Basically let not only the American people know, but let the Senate know as they get ready to go into deliberations that taxes are not on the table. We're lucky to have that.
Well, thank you very much. You have made it.
My wow, day. That's
President.
Good.
All that it takes to uphold a veto. Well, I really appreciate this because I feel very strongly. Taxes are not the answer.
They are not the answer. And all of my people are on your side on that, the people that I represent.
Bo, as you probably know, is a freshman member of the Congress, and so he just worked hand in hand with me to get these signatures.
I think that's great. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Appreciate it.
God bless you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
She's sunshine, that's what she is.
Good morning, all. Start off here with a matter of national security, Nicaragua, funding for freedom fighters. I guess that comes as quite a surprise to you. You know, of course, on April 4th, the report that we sent up there and we asked what had been going on in Nicaragua. And that report started the clock rolling to a vote on funding the freedom fighters later this month. Last night I spoke to that group of citizens that is organized to raise funds, had a fundraiser for the Nicaraguan refugees. And one young man that was brought up with a platform was a young Pentecostalist minister. And his story, I'm sorry, so far the press this morning, I hope later on somebody will rectify that and really show him. They came in the night and they woke him and they took him out, they tied him to a pillar of the building and then poured gasoline in the building and set it on fire. The Lord was watching out for him because the fire burned the ropes, which freed him, although his clothing by then was in flames and he was burning and he fled. Some campesinos found him, took him to a hospital. There was a lie about how he was burned and all. But to see that face up close as I did when he came up there, he will bear the scars forever, what they did. But to get on with the business here, when I announced that plan that I was putting forth a new peace proposal that involved a ceasefire and negotiations mediated by the Catholic Church, I also stated that we would then use the $14 million in assistance to the freedom fighters for humanitarian and non-lethal assistance if serious negotiations were underway. And by providing this assistance, I think we create incentives for the Sandinistas to negotiate. And I've received letters supporting my proposal from the presidents of all the countries neighboring on Nicaragua. And even before the letters arrived, I had called personally, not only including them, but including the president of Venezuela, Argentina, and I've got the president of Spain. And all of them really went along talking to each other and so forth about this. And hey, as you know, Costa Rica came up here on his own to see if he could be of help. And I know that there's a lot of opposition in the Congress to providing aid to the freedom fighters, but I believe much of this opposition is based on a misunderstanding of what is really happening in Nicaragua and the long-term threat that is posed by America's interests. Or to our interests, the Sandinistas are, there's no question, about Marxists. They're exporting subversion and revolution throughout the Central American region. Through our intelligence and through public speeches and statements of the Sandinistas, they've made it clear they are seeking a revolution without borders. Now, our policy's been and remains one of seeking to end an end to their subversion and return to the democratic.
Mr. President, the President of Senegal.
Yes. Well, welcome. It's good to see you again.
I'm so happy to see you again.
Well,
thank you.
You
look well.
I feel good.
You look well.
Come in.
This is the foreign minister. Come on, tell you.
Wave of photographers. It will be coming.
Certainly enjoyed that visit yesterday, sir.
Yes.
Hope we didn't keep you late for your
No.
President and Mrs. Diouf came out of the house and had a nice visit yesterday evening.
Upset your schedule, Mr. President. I know how busy you are, so I'm very embarrassed to have caused disruption in your schedule.
Not at all. It's a great pleasure to see you. I'm just sorry that it has to be such a greeting. Well, we have looked with admiration on your progress you've been making, Mission Bear. And I know that the OAU is, I understand.